We are the book that this generation is trying to read.
When it comes to leadership and structure, we are serious. We mean what we say and we say what we mean.
The ELC has broken the fourth wall. Can't you hear it?
The choice that future generations have rests in the choices that we have today.
What you owe to the nation is your own personal development.
Leadership is extremely important. It can inspire you to the place where you actually believe you can do anything. So now you can see that success is addictive.
So, our first UK candidate of the ELC parliamentary elections is Charlie Goldmxn.
So easy to take out a university loan. But being a young entrepreneur is so hard to take out a loan to start up your business. The Americans have their dream, but where is ours? Yeah. Entrepreneurship, leadership, community building, mobilization, and last but not least, the ability to withstand pressure. We aim to roll this out by 2026.
A system that is not just based on a 5-hour lesson. It will teach you the life skills that's also involved in driving, that benefits not only businesses, but also the wider economy and society as a whole. And the last one is economic growth through trading internationally. Leader of the new ELC Gen Party is Charles Goldmxn.
Trust me, in no other country on earth have I seen these kind of stories within this room. A set of young people who are breaking limitations, breaking barriers, and that's what happens when the system fails and our politicians promote evil. So join me. Let's find the missing voices in these communities. Because should we find it, I guarantee you the establishment will come down crashing, because it already is. The old institutions are shaking, the old ideas are failing, the system has crumbled, and a new generation has come.
NHS may have been built on heroic ideology, but now it's being held up and propped up by the goodwill of those who serve within it. Nurses, mostly every day, stay beyond their contracted hours to make sure that their patients are looked after, only to receive a wage each month that still places them below the poverty line. Being a doctor is no longer an automatic signing to be respected within the community. In fact, it's not unusual for doctors to receive racist abuse from the people that they're trying to help. And it's not unusual for patients to disagree with the information provided because Dr. Google has already told them that their simple headache is actually a brain tumor and they've only got 48 hours to live.
What would I want to hear if I was an aspiring lawyer from a low socioeconomic background sitting in the audience today? And with that, I have titled my speech, Unlocking the Potential of Diverse Intelligence to reshape the legal industry. Thank you to the economic leadership team for this platform, and especially to Pastor Onyi, who has mastered the skill of getting me to do things that I quite frankly wouldn't like to do.
But even choices require tunnel vision, which is something that many of us will call facing your front, which is a topic for another day. The ELC's vision of becoming influential and economically powerful individuals isn't just a dream.
Our country is in a drought of young, vibrant leadership and needs our help. We have been denied the results that we deserve. It is time that we face our fearlessness and resilience. I charge you all in this room with a sense of urgency to consider that without us creating a young parliament, our voices may never be heard.
And as long as I've lived, the government aren't giving me that. So we're here to make a change, can't you feel it? The land where creeks are formed, creating an allegiance, setting systems so that visions have the freedom to rule nations and carry those that don't believe until they believe it. An economic class of leaders. The future started yesterday. Join us to enter the Chamber of Secrets. Thank you.
There is not a deficit in skilled workers. There is a deficit in skilled leaders. If there's poor healthcare, poor educational system, or poor infrastructure, it is not because of lack of expertise. It's because of lack of leadership. My first statement, the nation family is undoubtedly the Silicon Valley of producing world-class leaders. We have a system and we are committed to the development of that system because it continues to develop winners. Economic Development Centers is our system.
They need me to go, but I don't want to leave. Rest in peace, Lil' Keith. Pigeonhole, I'm a night out, it's a different mode. I'ma have to make a paint of six on a pinky toe. Heard you with a shooting guard, just let it know. I would have your court side, not the middle row. All good love in a minute though. I can't stress about no, cause I'm a timid soul. Plus I'm cooking up ambition on the kitchen stove. Pot start to bubble, see the suds, that good to go. Damn suave.
An economy of 140 companies growing with a combined value of over £16 million annually. He's the founder of the Economic Leadership Class, I'm the CEO of a forum to raise the bar of leadership globally to challenge leaders to stay focused on critical matters. Ladies and gentlemen, please help me and put your hands together for our founder, Pastor Onyi Goldmxn. Distinguished leaders of the nation family and all of our friends that are here this afternoon. I hope you've enjoyed the program so far. It's been absolutely iconic again for the ELC to be invited to Parliament. Thank you. But I must say everybody looks absolutely dapper and beautiful this afternoon. And of course, much great thanks to my leader, my pastor and father, Pastor Toby. Proven system and ulterior government of the nation family that over those years created thousands of jobs, thousands of volunteering roles, thousands of leadership opportunities and entrepreneurs. And you're a product of that as a 3G. I'm not sure if you remember in Grand Sapphire, one of these services that we had, where PT mentioned that we are the book that this generation is trying to read because they're unable to pick up the script. So we're gonna have to live an open life where they can see us, observe us, and take from us. The volume one of the ELC journal is just the beginning of that. I wanted to just share this with the third generation, that you should continue to uphold the values that we've set. Values of leadership, the values of meticulous attention to details, and the values of never thinking anything can't be done. If you follow down that line, you will eventually arrive at the point where you see a Pastor Sepp or a Pastor Onyi Kabobi. They look like gods, but they were just young boys too. So it's all down to how well within this model have you followed? Because this model is proven. We were taught that the questions are actually within us, and also there lies the answers. So now we have so much confidence in the model because the model has produced and is driving us to a new place. The mind that sparked this allowed us to redefine our belief system. Belief system like the ELC Journal Volume 1, that as far as you can see something, it can happen. So PT said something to me, he said, so now you can see that success is addictive. And that has stuck inside me since the second ELC Oxford. And now I know why successful people don't like sleeping. Success feels so good. I want you to help me welcome to the podium Pastor Toby Adeboye.
Sparking your mind or introducing you to a dimension, I thank you for carrying it through for the sake of these young and brilliant people. When I got here, I was terrified. All I knew was churching. I didn't even know you can create a system, but walking out of that place, knowing there's no chance that these guys will understand our unemployment. They'll never understand it. I just thought, we're just going to create a counter-government. A government of the young, by the young, for the young. So I'm being disciplined. I don't need to enter my revolutionary mode or contain myself like P.O. According to P.O., I'm not the one, though. But I want you to think of something with me for just 10 minutes. We've done that, and what you've done today again, and what you've done over the years, is presenting that counter-government until the one that exists forcefully, because this is more effective. It's providing more jobs, it's taking more people off the streets, it's giving more people hope, and that's the job of government. Government is supposed to provide jobs, create conducive environment, not make people contained like UK does. Allowing them to dream, and like Charlie, who would have been the president-elect, but for the tribunal, is right now, said there is American dream. Where is the UK dream? So think with me on this. The title of this thought class is Next Gen, and I believe they mean next generation. What is not arguable is the fact that a generation is based on core values. Core values is what makes a generation, and I'll define that from our formative years, which is around 17 to 20 years old. Of course, your fundamentals will be set by the time you're 7, but formative years, 17 to 20 years old, early 20s, the people about our age will share the same teaching, the same core values will become a generation. Core values, the societal teachings and influence, depending on what year you are born, creates a belief system. This belief system determines core values. The core value of a generation determines their lifestyle, their relationship, either they want to be, as now we can see the world, you can choose to be a male or a female. It determines their mode of life and their choices and their preference. So you know what that means. It took leaders. Dr. Hemmer had given us a wonderful presentation about the NHS. It took minds. Minds that are frozen out. Minds that can think beyond borderlines. Think outside of the box to create that. Why is it suffering now? You've got to invest in social capital without looking at human capital, because everything comes out of human capital. The shaping of a generation is therefore determined by shared core values, which most times, until Gen Z came, is determined by conventional TV, certain leaders, musicians, and the likes. Gen Z. When television and all these adverts was trying to define our life, then came great gaming platforms. Computer people came. And our way of life and our core values started to change. The gaming platform started, and a lot of things started getting questioned. The way of life started getting changed, and things were shifting. The internet age was a change generation. The flow of information right now is unprecedented. Unprecedented. And it's uncontrolled. So you can find almost anything you want right there. I can give you facts now, and then you can just go on Google and just check if it is true or not. So Gen Z, people born between 1995 and 2010, they no longer need to create full strategy to create impact. They just need to create a tweet. Whereas in the past, if you're going to be a musician, you have to have strategy, you go to a record label, you go through all the rigmarole. A person can jump on TikTok now and just become what people say does not happen. They say, there's no overnight success until TikTok came. As if you can post a video, and if it is stand out enough, if it is controversial enough, you can wake up and the whole world knows you. That is overnight success. Who shaped this generation? Because this generation then begin to ask the church, begin to ask culture. They now can challenge things. When we were growing up, there are things we can never challenge. It is what it is, they say to us. But now, the Gen Z evolved, is getting more impactful because it can challenge things. We have what it takes to change the world. And I've been saying this since I was 25, in the hardest country to be a leader. Because this nation does not want leader. It wants a system. And it doesn't care how outdated it is. America and other nations of the world reproduce billionaires. When last have you heard that about UK? It's a leadership. So I charge you, as we launch the ELC journal, to read these things and think together, see the possibility and the system and a playbook that we're all working with as a house. The reason why you have this is for the sake of yourselves and your kids. Why? so that tomorrow they don't say, we checked internet, they said they just struck down your job. They said this happened. This is income analysis 2017. This is income analysis. You know, analysis is not just me showing you income, analyzing everything. Why? So that your kids can see how we've lived on record. Different from propaganda, I challenge any church in the UK today, anyone, if you're bold enough, bring out your analysis. Let us see your finances. So this 2016, we've got 8 to 9 years of analysis. I'm presenting it in the parliament to prove the attention to details of this work. That is leadership. That is revolutionary. Thank you all as we watch this. Thank you, Pastor Onyi, for the seriousness and your team of ELC. This is serious. You know, when it comes to leadership and structure, we are serious. We mean what we say and we say what we mean. Thank you all. May God bless you. God bless you.